Okay. Hey guys, we have now a session about the customer flow. As we introduced them a few weeks ago, and we still know that there are some confusions, there's a bit unclarity in the network about it. That's also why I'm recording it for all the people who will watch it later, because actually if I introduce it to you now and we start to have a conversation about this, I can also directly use this for all the people who are else in the network and who cannot be here and join the discussion.
Question?
So, yeah.
Is Naresh coming?
No, we left.
Then we can continue in German.
No, because if I'm recording it and we have people in the network who cannot speak German,
okay.
Then I would like to have it. If it's okay for you.
Yes, of course.
It's for me at the moment easier to do English than in German. Yeah, what we have here? The customer flow, how I introduced it also before, we were sending you a video, but actually from some feedback I got was that the video was short. We wanted to make it short because if we send you a video about 15 minutes, not everybody will look it, but now you have to because there's unclarity about it. But there are some points within this customer flow where we have discussion, where we have to discuss about, because it's still some unclarity about it. So I would like to first go through the whole process, and then we talk about, then I point some things out where I think we have to talk about, and afterwards you can also ask me just questions you have about it, and then we can also talk about this. Okay, cool? So the customer flow, how it looks now, we have as visitor stranger, we call the person here lead. And the first thing, what is to do, what we have to do is the market research, this is what marketing is doing. No, it's still.
Okay.
I hope it's still recording. Yeah. We have the. This is the part marketing is doing. We make a market research. We try to attract the people, and we try to bring everybody to opportunities portal. This means for us at the moment we are working in the marketing to bring all the people to AIESEC.de. From AIESEC.de at the moment it's still that if the people click on sign up, that they are linked to our Salesforce registration form, but. Hopefully next week, I'm not sure, because we are really, really depending on AI and how the system is going to work and what are the issues and bugs we have at the moment. As soon as this is working properly, we think we can do this, then we switch the link that they directly go to Opportunities Portal. And from this on, there's the opportunity for everybody in the exchange functions that we can use the CRM system of the Opportunities Portal to work with them. Should we do the questions now or later? Because it's marketing, right? So first go through this, and then you ask the questions for it, and then you go through the others.
Mm-hmm.
So we have the opportunities portal here, where we try to bring everybody to, sooner or later. Then they look there for opportunities, and they have to complete their profile, because if they haven't completed their profile, they cannot click the apply button. They can start see some opportunities. Also, there are more ideas from AI how to do this in a more smart way. But actually for us now, important is they have to complete the profile before they can apply. And then we can go on with the process. What was your question about?
No, it's more like about the sign-in thing. I just want to tell it directly, because if you want to get information on the page and you scroll down to the actual Global Citizen programs, you come to the blind selection, which is,
yeah,
for the customer the most confusing thing you can do.
Okay, this is another topic we can talk about. At the moment, it still makes sense. For later, we will also think about how we can deal with this and how we go on with blind booking, but at the moment it's an additional tool for us to give them a more clear picture of what they can do with us, because the search function of Opportunities Portal is still not that amazing as we want it to be, even if it's better than myisec.net was before.
The problem with that is, like, if you are the customer and you go to the website and you think, okay, the sign-in button is directly at the front, at the first thing you see.
Yeah.
And then you think, okay, first I want to see what opportunities I have. So you scroll down,
yeah,
and see, okay, there are the projects which I can apply for. This sounds interesting. Then you want to apply for a project, so you select on project, and then you're not coming for the normal sign-in, but for the,
yeah,
for the blind,
yeah,
thing, which is, it's for the customer flow, or as a view of, and the view of the customer, it's,
yeah,
really...
It's confusing. We know it at the moment. We split them kind of. We have people who are signing in with blind booking. We have people who are signing in with a normal registration form. As this is anyway going to change, at the moment the whole flow is not as smart as we want it to be. So we have to the situation is at the moment like this. We are still on thinking about how to improve it. But the first step is to switch completely to opportunity portal. And then the next step is how to use, maybe at the beginning, still blind booking to give them better overview about what they can do, another opportunity to find suitable TNs. And then we think about maybe this is also later somehow included in the whole process. But for this, you can we can learn, we can definitely discuss about it, and we can also talk with Harvey about it. But anyway, next week I will also have a meeting with him to talk about how we are going to do this with opportunities portal and blind booking in this way. As soon as we come to the point that we would switch it.
Okay. And the next thing was just like, as you said, now we should send already the people to the opportunities portal. Yes or no?
We should at the moment send for the recruitment everybody to AIESEC.de. But if you have them on AIESEC.de, at the moment you get them in Salesforce, but the people from Salesforce, sure, you have to contact, like we did this before, and there you can send them to Opportunities Portal already, yeah. But there you have the communication beforehand and tell them, like, at the moment it's not, it's still, we changed it, it's still in the process, it's getting better, and we will support you with finding something, and later on, like when they go directly, you don't have probably not the, there are a contact in between, that's why we are waiting with switching this, till the point when we say there's, it's customer friendly enough that they do not directly need the guideline from us or can get the guideline maybe in a different way. Okay? Yeah. Okay, when the person applied, they are now a lead for us. They are not yet a customer, but they are a lead, someone who is interested. What we agreed and what all the VP, OG's VP agreed on this and also the VP of GIP is that actually if you would apply, if you would write an email to a company, you would expect from this company that they answer you within 24 hours. This is like what we in Germany have as a normal expectation. So we said actually if there are people telling us they are interested in our programs, we should try to answer them as soon as possible, because if we are talking about quality we want to deliver, this is part of our quality we have to deliver. So we agreed on, we try to contact them within 48 hours as a measurement for us. We will think about the concept how we can support you with doing this also, because you have to kind of find a way on do this with your members, which is not that easy sometimes, I know it, I was by myself VP of GX. But this is the next step we agreed on. What we have here, something we will talk later on about. Normally you would get in contact with them and you would have a personal talk. And here we have another option we will give you as a concept, which is the induction concept. I think it's better if you talk about it completely later, but this is everything we are giving you as opportunity is not you have to do this, it's always an opportunity for you and you find your own way of how you can go through this process as suitable as possible for your local reality. If you have the opportunity to give everybody who is applying in your local committee a personal talk, for sure that's the best you can do, because this is the most connection you have to your EPs. Maybe we will come to a point later where this is no longer possible in this way, and then we have to think about several steps we can also do on how to deal with all the people who are interested in our program. I will come to this in detail later. After this induction, they have to, or during this induction maybe, or afterwards, like in the personal talk or in the induction, they have to sign the contract. And for OGAP, they also have to have an interview with a company, because they still have this part. For OGCDP, they don't have this mandatory. Some are still doing it, but the ideal customer flow from AI is that there's no longer an interview. Because actually, if we have an interview or they have an interview, it's basically between personal talk and interview, maybe 2% of the customers are kicked out or not longer interested, and all the others are still going on GCDP with us. So here we try to reduce our effort we have. If they sign the contract and they're still looking for opportunities, and then they get at one point the acceptance for a project abroad, like the other LC in this other country is saying, yes, I would like to have you for this internship. I would like to have you for this internship. I'm offering this to you, like the virtual TN from the other side, virtual AN from the other side, acceptance note. And then the EP can say, okay, I want this too, and can sign also virtually the acceptance note. What has to happen then is that here the EP has to pay before we say we confirm this match. Because we said for us, this is the customer flow, like we want to have it, and we want them to pay when they found the opportunity. Because this is one of the most significant changes we have in the customer flow. We do not longer let them pay for having a look in our pool of projects, but now we say you have to pay when you found your opportunity. This is one of the big. This is a really, really big change for how you can argue to get people that they're interested in our program and really do this with us. And we no longer have this problem with people who are falling out later and want money back and didn't find something. And so what is here? There's still something we have to change because of this. Because at the moment in our contract is written they have to pay within 2 weeks, but now from the customer flow we say they have to pay after they found something. So what we have to do on BMV in four weeks, is that 2 weeks now, okay, soon on BMV, we have to change the AGBs again and just delete this one sentence, you have to pay in 14 days. And then they can from there on, we can from there communicate in that way that they have to pay when they want to get matched, because it's still written in the contract, we confirm your match only if we have all the documents and your payment. But at the moment, still this part of 14 days, and we will cross this out. For now, we will have to find a way of how to communicate it. Actually, I think it's possible that you normally just cross something out in the contract before you sign it. But also there, I think we should just, for this few weeks, we should find a way on how to communicate it with the EPs who are interested, and afterwards we do not have the problem anymore. So they pay after this, which is one of the best changes we have in our process. And then we confirm it. And what they have to do now is they have to still do an OPS as a preparation before they go abroad. And here it's the same like with the induction. Probably, I will come to this later, we have many, many more applications than we had before. And it's again something we were thinking about. How can we give you opportunities to deal with this as good as possible before maybe the situation is going to appear and we are not prepared for it? So what we think, even at the moment, we have the demand from people that they need an OPS and we are not able to deliver it to them. We have a lot of OGLP, well not a lot, but still, we have some OGLP people who are making short-term offline match and go abroad in 2 weeks and we are not able to deliver them an OPS and we still send them abroad. The thing is, it does not count for as an exchange for you. You have to pay a punishment for this because of the management report, because something is missing and they are not prepared for it. So what we need here as an opportunity is OPS online, what we are working on at the moment. We cannot give you a concrete deadline till when it is there because this is a huge project and there are many, many things we have to consider. We even do not have a concrete concept for this yet. We just know we have to start looking for this because the demand is definitely there. And also there, this is not a have to. Even if we have this, we still say you should do physical OPS and physical op course, because I would recommend op course because I'm a fan of it and the experience is much better for our EPs. And if you are, even now, if you have the opportunity and if you're able to deliver this to all your EPs that they can go to OPCO or OPS, please do so and send them there. And this is then the additional, will be an additional thing that we can offer the other people also, that they can, that those who are not able to go there, that we can offer them, they have another opportunity to prepare for going abroad. We also do not have criteria yet because the concept is not there. We can at the moment not say who should do this and who should do this and who is allowed and who is not allowed. So the whole discussion about maybe the people then only go there and do not longer go to our physical OPS, but we want them to be there. The discussion is too early because we do not have the concept yet. We just know that we need to talk and need to think about it and we need to create this. After they did this, in which way ever, they get realized and they go abroad. There they will get from Opportunities Portal reports. I cannot tell you more about how this will look like because also they will be implemented later. But there they have also to fill out reports on how everything went with them, which was also different than the communication we had before, because I thought there's just an NPS they get, but it looks like they're also getting reports. We will see, and in half a year we know more. After they realized one of the things that we already changed on the NKK when we legislated the new RGB, for completing your experience with us abroad, you have the three things. You have to fill out the NPS, you have to attend the Welcome Home Seminar, and you have to give us, we call it not testimonial, which is just another word for the returning report they had all the time, but marketing thinks there's I was talking with Javi about it, it's a more nice way if they can give us this in the form of a testimonial that we can use it better for the marketing, and that we collect all this in one place. But basically this is what was before the returning report. As it's written, we can set the criteria on how this should look like by ourselves. So we can do it in this way. And the Welcome Home seminar, it's already introduced to you. There's the concept and everything prepared. And the NPS also. The additional information NPS will be implemented later in Opportunities Portal. They said it will be around December, which would be fine for us because our EPs are going in around February. But also there, if we get more information from AI on how, when this will happen, and if it's not early enough from us, we have a ECB, an entity control board, who will then take care that we have a quality evaluation from our EPs who are going abroad, because it's one of our measurements we have for this year, that we want to achieve a certain amount of quality and want to have this also evaluated, so we will ensure this with this. And after this complete stage, the EP is done with this exchange, and then we think about how to get him to a promoter, or which is also a bit related to the Welcome Home seminar, but here also for us important, how to get them to be member of AIESEC. So we said we want to have the Welcome Home seminar in one day, and if we would include this part of, are you interested in AIESEC, it would not be possible to do this in one day. Because we need this one day really to get them reflect about the experience, what is really, really important for them. So we said we will split this, and during this Welcome Home seminar, there's a session about, hey, you did all this with AIESEC, and how did you like it, and are you interested? And if we then find out, like without pressure, but still with asking the right questions, then we can see who is interested, and we will offer them reintegration talks, what TM is working at the moment, that someone from TM can sit together with them and can go through this with them again and explaining them what was their benefit of it. For example, there is this module, a model of skills you can deliver by an exchange experience or also with an AIESEC, what are our functions and GDs and so on, and you tell them it's based on, and you can try to build a bridge between this and can say, here, this was your exchange and you developed skills in this and this and this area. And if you now would go on with an AIESEC, you can develop skills in this and this and this area. And if you would build a concept like this and want to explain it here, it's too early. This is too complex at this point. That's why we said, we can have a nice talk here and can talk with them. And even if they're interested in this, we could include this. But for more information, you will have to later on ask TM about this. So this is the whole constant customer flow. How we, in the ideal case, see this for us now. We know that there are still some bottlenecks. For example, the induction and the OPS online. And as I mentioned now within this presentation, what we are working on are opportunities for you. Because it was not purpose from my side, for example, that I was introducing this in a bit different way when I had the summits a few weeks ago. Because at this point I thought it would be in this way how I introduced it. But then we had the AI visit and we had this this replanning with Anna from AI. And she gave us a really interesting information about how the whole next year with opportunities, or how the next time with opportunities model will look like. And one of the facts, how I can give you maybe this hint, how this will look like is, before the opportunities portal was actually also there last year, and they called it ORS, and it was at this moment not connected to anything, it was not launched and it was not promoted. And on this ORS, they gained globally, within 12 months, 230,000 applications worldwide. 230,000 applications worldwide without promoting this. And the same thing they developed now as the opportunities portal, as the front end of our XPA, and have linked it to everything, and now we are promoting it, and they are even promoting it in a way more efficient way, because they are going to, for example, pay Google for it, that if you type in experience abroad or internship or whatever, that opportunities portal is going to appear, because this is what we want them to see there. With this, sure, the people who get attracted with this are way, way, way more. So what we planned, we can come to questions in a second. What we planned now is like maybe a little bit too low. So what we need to have in mind by going through this is where do we have bottlenecks if we have a lot of people interested in? How can we set expectations that those people who are over 30, and those people who are graduated like more than 2 years ago, that we select them beforehand, that we have directly the people we can work with, and how can we then work with them through this process, and especially where do we have bottlenecks that we can work with them. Because still we want to at least answer everybody who is applying for us. We want to get in touch with them, we want to talk to them and see who we can send abroad. We have the bottleneck definitely of the personal talk, because if we have so many applications, how should we do this? We have a certain amount of members who are working with us, and we have to find a way on dealing with this. And the same with OPS, where we at the moment even not able to deliver to everybody an OPS physically. So if we have way more, there's again a challenge. The thing is, these are all challenges, and what we're doing now is trying to be prepared as good as possible, be prepared for this, because nobody of us can say how it really will be. It's just that we have to expect that it will be a bit different as we're used to it. So here we have, for example, for the induction, let's say an ideal case for you now would be if all your plannings would went perfectly, you get especially as many applicants as you want, you have enough members for this, you can offer everybody a personal talk. Then everything is fine, and nobody is forced to do this, because this is not a concept you would use if you're able to do a one-on-one talk with everybody. And the personal connection would be there, and you could have the normal EPJDs. Everything is then like kind of what we had before in this related to this point. But if you go through and think about the other extreme, and you would have now, we would have in Germany like 20,000 applications instead of this around 5,000, we may go a bit less we planned with. So how would we then deal with this? And this is like, we thought about, okay, we need something to set expectations with them, what they have to be aware of, in a way that we give this to all these people who are at the moment interested with us. And we know that, let's say, the most extreme way would be we have an induction and a presentation with all these expectations. We would have this online delivered on Adobe Connect once a week from our MST. Sure, super extreme. And the thought is like, we need a while to get used to this. But this is the super extreme way. So let's take one step less. We say, you have this in your LC once a week delivered by yourself. One step again below, you have this in your LC once a week as induction combined with an assessment center, and have after this expectation setting for everybody, you have like one-on-one, one-on-three, one-on-five, one-on-ten, smaller group talks with them, whatever is possible then for you. And one step below then would be something in the direction of a personal talk. So there we have just opportunities we can use adapted to the situation that will appear. But what we have to have is like this induction concept to as this opportunity that we can then start playing with it related to the situation that we have to face in this moment then. And something similar is the background to this OPS also. If we are able to send everybody to OPS and OPCO physically, please do so. I'm a fan of a MIG. My MIG was a really nice experience for me. I was not perfectly prepared, by the way, and was still super overwhelming for me, which brings me to the point that sending the people abroad and giving them this experience is still a super valuable opportunity for them. I was totally overwhelmed with my experience, and I say it's one of the most valuable experiences I had in my life, and it changed my life completely, still, even if I was so lost. That's why I, for example, said from the beginning on Welcome Home Seminar is super important for them to reflect afterwards. Because there's also something we can work on the quality for them. But still, if we're not able to give this to everybody, and we have already people who are going abroad without nothing, it is important that we have something for them. And this is another opportunity. And we still, as soon as we have more details about the concept, we can start communicating about this, we can start giving us feedback. We know that there are specific things of this OPS who are really important and where we see bottlenecks. Like the simulation, we cannot do this in the way we had it before, but maybe we will find nice opportunities, nice solutions for this to give something similar to them in this way. Or maybe you make it that you have some parts online and some parts in smaller seminars or whatever. We can think about opportunities for this. But we have to be aware of why are we doing this and how are we going to. We are not saying to you, you have now to use this. Because I think this was maybe something that was a bit misunderstanding we had, because the communication was super fast after this visit. we are aware of this, and we are also sorry that not everything from the communication is super clear, but we want to talk with you about it, and we want to go through this together. So the discussion is needed. That's why we are talking about this. Okay. Do you have questions to this? You had a question, right?
I have three or something. But regarding that, first of all, I wanted to know, when you talk about like restarting AdWords campaigns for Google, that the marketing AdWords campaigns.
Okay.
Or if we also would be allowed like to do it on local level, because if you learn how to set up an AdWords campaign or a Facebook campaign, it's like really valuable knowledge for the real market.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not that hard though.
I have no idea. So this is an information I got for the first time from AI, from Anna at the replanning, and she said, just said that AI is going to do this, and I haven't heard about this before, so I do not know if Javi is doing this for us at the moment too. If the opportunity is there, I would recommend to you talk to Javi, because Javi has the connection to AI, and then we can say which level can do what. For sure, here also you have to think about the leverage effect, because if AI is doing this on a global level with Google globally, it has a different leverage effect than if you do it on a local level, but still for sure the experience for you would be valuable to know how this is going to work. And so get in touch with Javi and see if it's possible, or at least if it's possible, if you can have more insights about how this is working, because even this would be nice, I think.
Okay. And the next thing you said, like how we filter out people who are not fitting in our criteria.
Yeah.
Isn't this quite easy if we do the form right? Like, I mean, if you just say like, give your age, and you say like, you're older than 30, sorry, you're not fitting our program.
Yeah.
It's quite easy to.
This is something IT is working on. I think at the moment we started to put these expectations clear on our website, on AIESEC.de already.
Yeah.
But also there, people are not going to read everything. So you have to be aware of the fact that some people are going through this, just la 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 la, and sign up. So then there will be an opportunity spotter, but so far I understood from Dan that we have the opportunity, when they're going on opportunities portal and select the country, there are three opportunities for us, three different questions we can add, then related to the country, and then we can set expectations like this. But also there, for more details on how we're going to do this, Dan is the one we have to talk to.
But
this, yeah.
There are really quite easy solutions. For example, just use your university email address and give your age, and that's done.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the next thing was when you said like for the OPS process, how we're gonna implement it after that, because you said like we're not having yet a solution.
Mm-hmm.
I think we could also like look at other organizations, because there are a lot of organizations for going abroad who have the same problem and they do the same stuff. And they have like, for example, one big expectation talk. I know that because my friend went abroad or something like that, where they meet all together from all Germany and the people do it.
Yes.
So if we make it professional in a way like that,
if you have hints for this, we are super welcome to share them with us. Share them with Nancy, because Nancy will be responsible, as the training area is highly involved in this, and Nancy is responsible for this. She will be head of this. Nevertheless, sure, I will also be try to give my input and see how this is going to work and try to support this too. But yeah, this is definitely, it's a challenge for us, and we are looking for a lot of opportunities and how we can do this. So this would be really valuable if you have some information about it. Yeah.
It's a question that I'm a bit concerned. If you do this induction process, and then you said like, if we have a lot of EPs and you don't have personal talk with everybody, then you just have the interview with the OGIP EPs, right? That's what you said, like,
yeah.
And with the OGCDP people, I have like, can we still ensure that it's a high quality experience for the EP who goes abroad, for the TN taker abroad? Because if you just say, okay, it's just OGCDP, we don't need an interview, just go out.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that the quality will still be up high, because like, I know that a lot of people, what goes like in our LC, they go abroad and they're not happy at all with the GCDPs within the last month. And I think if we then also from our side, the people we send abroad, it's not only the age and what they study, but it's also their personal, like what kind of character are they? Are they ready to go abroad and to do such a project? And I think you can only check this if you have a personal talk to ensure high quality EP.
Yeah, I know what you mean. this is also a challenge we have to face. The thing is, still, I know that a personal talk is the only thing, or at least a better personal connection is the best way to find out if these people are able to do this. And we have to see how it's going to look like for the next, when we go once through the flow, we can evaluate everything, and also this will be a big part of it, definitely. Still, it is the fact that we select 98% of our people. So sure, we are not that much aware if they would fit to it, but on the other hand, before we knew it, and we also sent them abroad. I know that this is, it is different, and it's a new way, and we have to see if it's working or not. And yeah, it is, how to say, we put a lot of effort in this selection process before, from both sides, OGAP and OGCDP, and for us, it was not that we had to interact that often. So as we have at the moment problems with several parts of the customer flow where we have to put a lot of effort in, it's just a normal way that we have to reduce it on another point. This does not mean that this is the ideal customer flow, like AI is going to have it, like AI introduced it to us, and they said just for OGCDP it's not longer necessary. Still some entities are doing it. Still, they are going to communicate, at least via email, and sometimes say, yeah, let's have a quick chat, let's have a good talk. I mean, it's not even an interview what you have for GCDP. It's always just a talk to say, hey, hi, how are you, la la. And then they say, yeah, cool, you're fine. And at the moment, also, the incoming GCDP side is still on trying to go through this process and trying to adapt to this. We will see where it's going to lead to. And then we can see on how we can evaluate it. As they're anyway at the moment still kind of doing it, and as we anyway at the moment do not know in detail how the selection and matching process is then, because we haven't went through it so far, we have to see. And then we can evaluate, and then we can see if we can again find solutions for bottlenecks we will find. Still see some faces who are a bit... question marks? Yeah.
It's a sign-up process, like you told us. Now the prospective EPs are going to like our website, sign up, and then will be directly linked to the opportunities portal.
Mm-hmm.
But will it be also connected to Salesforce?
Okay. The idea is that from the point on when we switch to opportunities portal, there will be, it's not the idea, but it's the fact, there will be a lack in Salesforce of people we have there for a certain time, because the NIST is already working on this, how to connect Salesforce and Opportunities Portal or an XPA, because they will make it that there's a sync between the customers. But till they have arranged it, they said it will need a while. I think for optimistic, for months or something, we will have a lack on data in Salesforce. Which is fine, because we, from the outgoing exchange area, can work with a CRM model we have in the Opportunities Portal, because this is working there. And then the only thing we would need Salesforce at the moment for is for our old EPs, because we have to get them to Opportunities Portal, that we have everybody there. And then we have to ensure that they paid, they signed the contract and they paid. But we are not going to give you now a new Excel sheet where you sign, where you put all them in and then say they have signed. And you can find a way for this by yourself to still have an overview about the people from in your local area. And later on, we can find solutions on how to do this again with the connected Salesforce and Opportunities Portal. Yeah. Yes.
I have another question about the testimonials.
Yeah.
Does it make sure that we are always get this Unterschrift?
That we can use it?
Yeah, that we can use it for marketing reasons,
yeah.
And publishing.
We have we have the AGB, and we have the signing part. Actually, this is the contract. And at the contract, we say for data security, data shots, that we can use the data. And we also added another point that we can use their report for AIESEC advertisement, and another point that we can use pictures and videos from their exchange, from their story, and they always have to tick if they agree or write their name. I think they have to tick it if they agree on or not. So it's just we will kindly ask them when they sign it if they would be fine with this. And then we can also try to, it's a way of how you communicate it, that we don't force them, but we would like them to support us with this. And then if they give us the report or the testimonial, and if they give us pictures and so on, we already have the signature from them in the contract form.
So they,
I thought it's a smartest way to ensure this.
So they don't have to. So they don't
have to. They don't have to. You cannot force someone to say, you have to give us your pictures. Yeah.
A bit concerned about the e-buddies. So
yeah.
We have way more applications and way more EPs.
Yeah.
How will it work? Because more than 5 EPs at the moment is too much, I guess.
Yeah. We are also aware of this, and this is also a challenge we have to face and where we have to find a solution for it. At the moment, for example, I had the task for me and my NST to set up new JVs for the outgoing exchange here for OGCDP till last week. And as we haven't went through this whole process, it's super hard for us to say how the JVs will look like in detail. I think in half a year we can set more detailed things. At the moment we have kind of ideas how it can look like. But should the JV of someone who is working in the OGX or OGCDP or OGAP area will change completely. It will not longer be like it was before. There's this part of going with them through this process from my AIESEC.net, which was a huge part of it, and it's totally not there anymore. There are other parts of the process where you have to go with them, and also we will have to see how this is going to look like. But again, there I can say, if we say if the situation would be related like this, that you have so many applicants that you can work with your HR capacity you have, you can have personal talks with everybody, and you can OPS physically or OPCO physically, and you have an EP buddy who is one-on-one, super in personal contact with them, like for 5 people, then it would be, everything is fine. If we have way, way, way more, we started already with having things here, and then we have also to start about thinking how we can handle this and still have the most personal connection as possible for the situation. But I cannot tell you now, you should make them aware of being buddy for 20 or 50 or I don't know how many, because the situation is not there yet. But also there we have to be a bit more flexible on how we can deal with it later, and we have to together find solutions for it related to the situation that is going to appear. Yeah, and I think if even beforehand they have a bit less workload, maybe we can put a bit more in this and then they focus more on it. But also there it's something, if we would now have many, many more members, then we could think about, then we had to, would have the problem of how to get them specific JDs and tasks that we do not lose them, and they always have to do something and are motivated, because if you just give them la-la work, you will lose them also. This is space for discussion, and we have to find solutions for this. But yeah, let's see how many applications we get, and then we have together to find solutions for this. But it's, you can already be aware of it that it will change. I think, are we in time a bit over?
Not at all.
Not at all. Okay. One last question, is it fine? And then I switch off the video and we can maybe have talks later about it.
Okay, so
oh,
it's okay.
Go ahead.
Okay. You said that there's a lack of a sales force or something for 1 month.
Yeah.
So should I make new sales force leads by myself for the EPs who signed the contract and paid the 350 euros?
I was also thinking about this. I still have to discuss it with Dan, because he said it kind of would be okay, because he can do it that okay, Salesforce will later get the information from XPAR and put it into Salesforce and create the accounts there, and he can ensure that they will not be double. I have no idea how this is going to work later. And we should discuss about this, if it would be a smart solution for you to do this in Salesforce again,
mm-hmm.
to create all of them, or if it would be enough if you would for 1 month just put them all in an Excel sheet and just say sign contract and paid. Yeah, we can try to see if this is an opportunity. If not, yeah, you have another Excel sheet, but I will not going to create this for you.
No.
Hamburg has a very good one, so
yeah, we should start to use our network for stuff like this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. We also have
so thank you very much. Thank you for showing, for looking at this.